This is a Swede Speaks.
One of my favorite movie series since I was a kid is the Back to the Future trilogy. In Back to the Future Part 2, the main characters, Doc and Marty, go to the future, to the year of 2015. That future has a dystopian trait. They are there to save Marty's children from their troubles. They are there to stop Marty's family from falling apart in the future. In this future, Marty's son, Marty Jr., participated in a crime and he was sentenced within hours of his arrest. Marty is shocked when he is reading an article from a future newspaper, quoting it. Within 2 hours of his arrest, Martin McFly Jr. was tried, convicted, and sentenced to 15 years in the state penitentiary. Shocked, Marty says, within 2 hours? Doc responds, the justice system works swiftly in the future now that they've abolished all lawyers. Well, Back to the Future Part 2 is a movie. It's not reality. At least, it's not the American reality, because citizens of the United States are protected by the Constitution. However, today's Britain comes close. Recently, Tommy Robinson was arrested outside of court in Leeds. He was there to document the trial of two Muslim men accused of rape. These men were going to get their sentences. Tommy Robinson was live streaming outside court. He made sure not to get too close to the actual building, and he did what any journalist should do. He reported on what was going on. For this, he was arrested for breaching the peace. Within hours of his arrest, he was tried, convicted for contempt of court, and sentenced to 13 months in prison. Wait, what? Did the United Kingdom turn into that dystopian future depicted in my favorite movie? On top of all of this, there is a media blackout in Britain. You're not allowed to report on this in the United Kingdom. But I don't live in the UK, so I will report. Britain has not abolished all lawyers. However, it has come to my knowledge that Tommy's solicitor will be meeting with him on Tuesday to discuss what next steps can be taken, if any. His solicitor was deliberately misled by the British police, who informed her on the phone that he was being released, and when she asked for confirmation that he would be released and that there was no need for her to travel to Leeds, they informed her that was correct. The police immediately took Tommy to the court and appointed a court solicitor who was useless. And then he was convicted and sentenced. Doesn't this sound like Britain turned into a pretty nasty place? Is it too strong to call it a fascist state? To me, this looks like fascism. I guess the statement, the fascists of the future will be the anti-fascists, was right. It has been attributed to Sir Winston Churchill. But it seems to be impossible to prove that he actually said that. But whoever said it was right. Make no mistake about this. The charges against Tommy Robinson is bogus. The British system just wanted to get rid of him because he is a threat to them. Take a look at the recent event in London, Day for Freedom. Thousands of people showed up. After Tommy's conviction, the street outside Downing Street, which is where the British Prime Minister has her official residence, was packed with people protesting the treatment of Tommy Robinson. Tommy Robinson is a man who is able to attract large crowds, and he demands freedom of speech, including the freedom to talk about how Muslim men organized grooming games to rape British and non-Muslim girls. Tommy Robinson actually sat down with Theresa May and explained to her what is going on. He is a threat to the British political elite and the mainstream media, to the British corrupt system. They want him out of the way, so they sent him to prison. Basically, sending Tommy Robinson to prison is a death sentence. British prisons are full of Muslim men who hate Tommy Robinson. So we have to stand by and support Tommy Robinson. Supposedly, he is okay so far. Thank God for that. Please pray for Tommy Robinson's safety and for his salvation, and pray for Britain. They clearly need it. If you want to send Tommy Robinson a letter, you can send it to A2084 CG Stephen Lennon, HMP Hull Prison, Hedon Road, Hull, HU95LS, United Kingdom. You can also email Tommy Robinson by using the service https://www.emailaprisoner.com/, And you can send small amounts of money to him, which he needs for postage stamps, phone calls, and foods or toiletries through https://www.secure-payment-services.com. I will of course post this information in the box below this video too. We are in a crucial time, and we have to stand by Tommy Robinson. I would also like to say a few words to the leaders of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. To Prime Minister Theresa May, I understand that you are a vicar's daughter and you went to a convent school, a Roman Catholic school. So I assume that you have studied at least some of the basic teachings of Christianity. I don't know what your personal faith or conviction is, but I assume that you at least have some knowledge about Christian teachings. Thus, you must know that one of the divine commandments is that you shall not give false testimony against your neighbor. I am also certain that you know that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ commanded that you shall do to others as you would have them do to you. Prime Minister May, you know this. Act on it. And to Her Majesty, Queen Elizabeth II, as far as I know, you are an actual believer. So you both know and believe in the Ten Commandments and in the teachings of Jesus Christ. I know that you are a figurehead, but if there was ever a time to tell politicians that they need to do the right thing, this is the time. I don't know what you can do, but please use your influence for good. So for those prayer warriors out there, pray for the people in power. Pray that God gives them wisdom to do the right thing. We have to realize that we are up against powerful and wealthy people. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely, as Lord Acton said. He was British, by the way. Anyway, we fool ourselves if we think that those in power today will give up that power willingly. And I was very recently made aware of a 2015 article claiming that councillors and police participated in sexual abuse of Rotherham abuse victims. There are many people in Britain who are trying to protect themselves by silencing free speech and by silencing Tommy Robinson. We can't let them get away with this, and we have to understand that this is a real fight. We must do it anyway. To quote Back to the Future, Part 2, again, in another scene, when Marty and Doc needs to change a dystopian present, and Marty asks Doc, "What if we don't succeed?" Doc responds, "We must succeed." So really, we have to stand by Tommy Robinson. He needs moral and financial support. And people who are trying to spread truth also needs both moral and financial support. This actually includes me. That's all I'm saying right now. Right now, support Tommy Robinson. And feel free to support me too. The more people who are able to fight this politically correct neo-fascist narrative, the better. Because I think that Britain is at a turning point. Britain can turn around, or it can descend into the abyss and turn into a full-fledged fascist state where the news are controlled and where you're not allowed to question political correctness or Islam. It is a spiritual, a moral, a political, and a financial battle. Pick your side. You can't be indifferent to this. And for now, that's what I have to say about this right now. I would like to thank everyone who supports my work. As you probably understood from what I just said, is really important and much appreciated. So if you like what I do, if you think what I do is important, please consider sending me a dollar or two, or 10, or 100. That's always greatly appreciated. And remember to support Tommy Robinson too. I will send him a letter. Please like and share this video, subscribe to this channel, and keep me in your prayers. Until next time, have a nice day, and God bless.